week, but this is our very first, like, official
Singeo stage.
Singeo stage, we're in.
I feel like we need a new jingle. We need, like,
Singeo stage.
Yeah, something.
Okay, somebody write us a jingle, please. Mm-hmm. So, welcome here. If you are joining us for the first time, we go live every week, and we have been forever inside of the Singeo members area. We're also streaming this to YouTube, just so that the whole world can come hang out with us and just talk about singing, which is, I mean, it's probably my favorite thing to do.
I know. I do it all the time anyway.
Speaking of favorite things, guess what happened this... had cake this morning.
Okay. In the morning?
In the morning. Cake. So Joy...
Is that legal?
Joy works with us, and she does things with numbers. Anyways, she had cake, and she just brought it into my office, and I had my coffee, and she placed this little piece of cake on my desk.
Well, let's just say you have not been shy about letting everyone in the world know that you enjoy cake.
No. It's so, and I'm just... I think our members can appreciate how delightful this is. It was a special kind of cake. It had almonds, and it had... like jam almost and layers.
So it's breakfast cake.
Obviously.
Yeah. That's great.
Anyways, I just completely derailed this already. So
we need one cake conversation per live.
Per hour.
Yeah.
I also think the sugar might have made me a little bit hyper.
Mm.
Okay. So first things first, we wanted to talk about a new release in the members area.
Mm-hmm.
So we just launched a new React video. I had never heard Chester Bennington's cover of Rolling in the Deep.
Mm-hmm.
And it was insane.
Yeah.
Did you like it? Good.
Yeah. His voice is crazy.
It's
so much power.
Crazy.
But also him singing a song like this seems like, whoa, you're like, it's just like so different from... music, right?
Like, some, like, you Linkin Park it. Moment. Right. You're all of a sudden you're hearing a ballad-ish from Adele, and it's crazy.
Yeah.
And we wanted to just show you a little clip. Mm-hmm. So if you're a Singeo member, you have this already. If you are a YouTube friend, then this is going to launch for you on Friday, I believe. Mm-hmm. So let's check it out. How are we doing? And there we get a little bit of distortion. So there, this is. It's really important to mention, if you're a singer and if you've taken vocal training, you know, we do all of this work to develop our voices, to find balance, to sing with ease, to eliminate our break, to do everything right. But then when you get into a performance like this, it's so important that you allow space for emotion, and portraying emotion and authenticity in a vocal performance, it sometimes takes over doing things correctly. Like, it would be more important that you get a little bit of distortion, that you get a little bit of grit, maybe you get a little bit of tension to show what it is that you're feeling when you're singing this. And this is what Chester is doing so brilliantly in this performance. But you played it with a beat. Little cry there. And singing that right into a closed mouth shape. Please don't be the end. I don't want this to be the end. More goosebumps. So we still have it going here. All right, okay. Oh, it wasn't the end. Good. Mm-hmm. Watch the video. What do you guys think about Chester Bennington? I want to hear your thoughts.
Yeah. I think Megan somewhere said she likes the React videos because it helps her, like, train her kind of critical sort of listening skills, like active listening skills that sometimes we just don't, like, when we're listening to music in the car or whatever on Spotify at home, we don't often listen with intention, like, actively. Mm-mm. And so sometimes hearing somebody else go through the song to be like, hey, here's what he's doing right now, and this is what's happening here, it can just be really, like, educational. It's like, oh my gosh, I wouldn't have noticed this before.
I was super resistant to doing reacts at the beginning. It's like, oh, just facial expressions and wow. Yeah. But the more I got into it, I didn't want to do that, but I realized it was such a beautiful teaching opportunity because you get to, like, experience music for the first time together, but also learn what those singers are doing and how you can apply those things to your own singing. So
it's true.
I love it.
Mm-hmm.
We have another really cool announcement we just need to remind you guys.
So the deadline for the duet roulette is this Sunday night. So I think October 9, which is Thanksgiving, by the way.
Oh,
great.
Lovely.
Oh, actually, I guess we can make the deadline the 10th because no one's going to do anything on the
10th. Nobody's doing anything on the 9th.
So if you would like to participate in the duet roulette still, please feel free to do that. You can go and just go to the I think the announcement is in the quick tips, but you can watch it all there and all the instructions. And if you need any help with recording, just let me know and we'll figure it out.
And for those of you who don't know, Duet Roulette is a super fun thing we do inside Singeo. So we pick a song, well, you guys pick a song, and then you learn the parts and you send us videos of you singing them, and then we pair you with partners, and then we collaborate this beautiful video, and they're the funnest
it's so
ever.
Fun, yeah.
Ugh.
Yeah.
So definitely.
I've got some submissions already. It's looking really good. I'm really excited.
Who here is planning on submitting but hasn't done it yet?
Mm. And what's holding you back? And do you have questions?
Yeah, because you got to do it. It's super important.
Megan is going to do it still.
Megan will do it.
Dan, you don't know this song? It's actually so easy to learn. It's like very short, and then it just repeats again. Like,
and the harmony part that I just was like na 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 na, same note. You call that an oblique harmony?
Oh, it's an oblique harmony. It's the one note harmony.
It's
I don't
the
know
one note
if you've
harmony.
Made it through level 9 yet.
level 9 is there. For
it's
you.
An easy and fun harmony to learn if you want to, but also don't worry about. Oh, I have to learn Nancy's part because I'm female. Don't worry about it. You can sing the melody or the harmony. It doesn't matter at all.
Absolutely.
Whatever's in your range, whatever's comfortable, and it'll be fun.
Speaking of melody and harmony.
Yes.
So Julie has informed me that the Beatles' Love Me Do debuted today
60 years ago. So on October 5th, what is that, 19,
a long 62? Time ago.
62?
Some years.
That was their debut single, The Beatles, Love Me Do, in the UK.
That's pretty exciting.
That's really cool.
Do we have any Beatles fans here?
Probably.
Richard remembers.
Oh,
really?
Oh,
I was born in the wrong era.
Yeah.
Like, really, truly, I was meant
was
to
a
be
a good time
earlier.
For music. I mean, yeah, it was.
So
we should sing a couple of bars.
Yeah, so this is a great song for us to sing together today because there's like... three notes in the melody. Da, da, da,
it's
da,
easy,
da.
Yeah, it's easy.
So.
Yeah, let's sing it together. So you should totally sing along. It's so easy. Love, love me do. You know I love you.
That's all the notes.
I'll always be true. So please love me do. It's like its own little melody, which is kind of nice.
Okay, so this is a harmony lesson. You guys are getting a harmony lesson. Okay, okay, okay.
Okay, pay attention, everyone.
Julia says that to me like 12 times a day. Pay attention!
Focus,
Lisa!
Okay,
focus.
So the melody is love, love me do, love. We're going to do the harmony just on the fifth below. Love, love me do.
What?
You know I love you. I'll always be true. It's the same three times. So please love me do.
Love, love me do.
Exactly.
So it's like,
you
na na.
I love you. I'll always be true. So please, same note.
Oblique harmonies.
Love me do.
I'm ready to try this.
Okay.
I'm ready to be brave.
So this is your starting note.
Love
me do. Ready?
Yep.
Love, love me do. You know I love you. I'll always be true. So please love me do.
I think I did it.
We should do it again.
One more time. Julia's way of saying keep practicing.
Love, love me do. Actually, they have so many really good harmonies, and it seems like they're always really well crafted. They're not often just like block harmonies. They're like real counterpoint like melodies that like they're really good. If you want to learn anything about harmonies, the Beatles are great to listen to.
You can quote me on this. If you want to supercharge your musician skills, you gotta listen to the Beatles.
Yeah, no, it's true. There's so much like musicality in there. It's just really, really good.
And you know what's the craziest thing about this? Is like that was like a three note melody, that song.
Right.
And a three note harmony. And it's still like there's a reason that they got to be the most famous musicians in the world. So
there you
go.
Okay, another thing happened yesterday.
Oh, yeah.
So I saw in the news, I don't know if you guys saw, but Loretta Lynn has passed away. She, at the age of 90, which, I mean, is like...
That's a long, beautiful life.
It is, right? Like, yeah. But then, so I heard this on the news, and he said her career spanned 60 years. Can you imagine? That somebody's just been working in the music business for 60 years.
And, like, one of the most iconic voices in country music.
Absolutely.
Who influenced, Dolly Parton, up to, like, Brandy Carlisle. So.
Totally.
Did you like how I knew a Brandy Carlisle fact?
Thank you.
Yes. Julia's a Brandy Carlisle super fan.
So much.
So.
Yeah. But, so, one of the things, I went through a couple of her songs yesterday just to, like, remind myself. Because I don't think I knew too many of her songs. Mm-hmm. Like, she's... Maybe a little bit too country. I like it, but like, I don't know.
It's not your, on your regular listening.
I haven't gotten into her songs yet, though I have always wanted a little wiener dog named Loretta Lynn.
Oh my gosh, that's so perfect.
And this will still happen one day.
You're gonna have to get another puppy.
I know. I'm working on it. I'm working on convincing my partner to let me have another dog.
You can be done.
To be friends with Mavis Staples, my other dog. So.
She's Mavis Staples. Oh, Mavis and Loretta, that would be such a great little pair.
And I just imagine Loretta Lynn to be like a long-haired dachshund with where I can make a little poof out of her hair.
That would be perfect.
That's aside from the fact that, so about, back to Loretta Lynn, the real person and human Loretta Lynn.
Yes.
I was reading about her that she was actually quite controversial in the songs that she sang.
Ooh.
Because, like, you know, when you look at her, she's, like, it's like very, like, 60s, 50s, 60s, like, the beautiful dresses and, like, prim and proper country music. I don't know. It's so cute. But lots of her songs were actually quite controversial.
Ooh.
So she sang songs about birth control. Like, she has a song named The Pill, which is, like, one of her most kind of famous and controversial songs.
Wow.
She sang about divorce at a time where you're not supposed to talk about it, right?
Like, well, I had no idea this about her.
Yeah, she's saying a lot about cheating because apparently her husband was like a known philanderer, apparently. Allegedly.
Allegedly?
Allegedly? Yeah. So she's singing a lot of songs about girls like, stay away or do you want to go to Fifth City? It's like, oh my gosh. But so she has the most banned songs from country radio ever.
Oh my gosh, I had no idea.
Yeah,
Loretta Lynn the Rebel.
Ever been upset about the Dixie Chicks like being banned from country radio?
Yeah.
She's like that times 10.
She started that.
Yeah.
Yes. Did you pick a song?
She's the original Rebel. I do have a song that we're gonna listen
banned?
To today. Yeah. No, this one was not banned. But this one is the Coal Miner's Daughter.
Layla called it. This is the one.
Yeah, so we're gonna have a listen to the Coal Miner's Daughter.
He shoveled coal to make a poor man's dollar. My daddy worked all night in the valley coal mines, all day long in the field of hoeing corn. Mommy rocked the baby that night and read the Bible by the coal oil light, and everything was be a
like that dress and the voice, just like so great.
I'm like, yeah. It was so great. I was playing along the piano, and I was
you're just playing along.
I want to learn that song.
I feel like her voice and her look reminds me very much of like June Carter.
Yes.
Yeah. Ugh. And she's definitely an alto too. So if you're an alto, it's good music
Laura
to listen
Lynn's
to
for you.
Mm-hmm.
So today. One of the things we wanted to experiment with a little bit in our Singeo stage is actually singing together.
Yes.
So
let's
what a
do
concept.
It.
So what I'd really, really like to do is do a warm-up with you guys. Mm-hmm. So I was like, if you're a piano player, a guitar player, a drummer, it's not 100% that you'll have your instrument with you, but I can tell you all right now, you all have your instruments completely on hand and ready to go. So unless you're like watching this while you're supposed to be working, you can sing along. And what I want to focus on today in our little warm up is actually going to be some pitch accuracy exercises. Uh-huh. So we're going to start with everybody's favorite warm up. So we're going to do this together. I expect you singing along. I'm going to start here on the bubble. And if you have a low voice, you can start down here. Okay, here we go. Okay, so now I want to do an exercise. I call this one the creaky door. So the point here is not to be loud. The point here is to be accurate. So you can just go
really quiet,
vocal fry. Yeah, it's not going to be loud.
Just a tiny touch.
Just touching each and every note, and it's supposed to be really bratty. Your mouth is closed, and all the sounds coming through your nose. The game, and we're gonna go. So the reason this one's so good is because up here you're probably in head voice. Even if you're with a low voice and you're singing down there, if you're a male voice, you're probably in head voice there. Female voice is probably in head voice here. So just touching the notes, and then what this creaky sound does is it lets you connect back to chest voice as you move down to the bottom really easily. So. Yes, Kelly, you will feel your core engaging a little bit as you go through these. And we'll head back down now. For everybody. I hope it felt good.
It feels good. As long as you're keeping it really light, it feels good.
If you try to force it, it's bad news bears.
Right.
And a lot of singers, especially, I find this more specifically in female voices that are used to singing classically or like in soprano, like more head voice coordinations. This one's very difficult to do up high because it's not what you're used to feeling because it's like that.
Because you usually don't want to be bratty up high,
exactly.
Right? I would always go, oh, I'm going to be,
exactly. So this is like, what's happening?
Yeah, it feels weird.
You can do little cries to practice it. Okay. Can I hear Kevin from down the hall? Kevin, I really do hope you're singing these exercises upstairs. that would be hilarious. Okay, so another one of my favorite pitch development exercises is an ugly app. And I'm actually going to pull something up on my phone for you. So if you... We're going to talk about this a little bit more later, but I have an app called Pitch. It's free. You can't really see it. But one of the ways you can check if you're doing this accurately is if I'm gonna play E, D, C sharp, B, A. If I play those five notes, this actually shows me that I'm playing those notes. So then I can try singing them back. Ah. Ah.
And you'll just double check that you're singing the right note. And you'll
say E. Yeah. There's the E. Ah.
Mm-hmm.
Ah. So it can kind of help you know if you're actually getting the notes. The problem with the pitch apps is they're meant for guitar, so they like...
they waver a lot.
There's a spectrum of accuracy. Yeah.
And all human voices are inaccurate.
Yeah, because our voice, especially if you have vibrato, naturally oscillates. So it's going to move back and forth. So just a little tidbit. We'll come back to that in a minute. But for now, bratty ugly. Short, just like the creaky door. It's not supposed to be shouty. If you put your tongue forward, it's actually going to help. Again, developing that pitch accuracy and really connecting to the notes. And this one is gug, Julia's favorite.
Ugh, I hate the gug.
Julia hates the gug. So what you can do is we're going to sing this on the long scale. And if you're new to the scale, it's a challenging one. So just do your best. Gug, 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 gug. It's pretty fun though, right?
I think because there's so much movement with g g g, it feels very strange in the back of your throat.
Yeah.
Like I really dislike this feeling.
Fair enough.
And then because it's like an vowel, I want to go kind of long, but I don't have time because this gug gug is like so fast.
Yeah, so.
It's very, like the whole thing is like, I feel very conflicted about it. I know it's good. I know it's very good.
So for Julia, that's so, because Julia has this incredibly trained voice. And she can sing classically beautifully. And so gug is like a no-no.
Yeah,
like,
I don't like
again, it. It's like,
but I'll do it.
Right. So this exercise, whenever we do exercises, they're to balance out our tendencies.
Right.
So for me, if I'm doing an exercise, I actually tend to have to focus more narrow because my tendency is to get a little too shouty and loud and belty. So I have to do something completely different for somebody who's more inclined to go like... head voice or mix or just wants to get like more bottom end on the sound, gug is perfect because it keeps you really bratty. Yeah, it's
it's good.
This is called exercise for a reason. I never go to the gym and think to myself, geez, I sure am enjoying myself.
No.
But I keep showing up for some reason.
It's true.
And the same is true for our voices, which are muscles. So I want to do one more with you guys. And now this one's a challenge. So one of the intervals for singers, it's one really challenging, is octaves.
Oh, we've not done octaves.
We've never done this
in the method.
Never before seen, because it's so hard. I thought it'd be fun to do. So if I try to do this on ooh, it's gonna be hard. Ooh is very flowy and free. So I'm gonna pick something that has a hard start.
Okay.
So gug would be great.
Yeah.
We could also do ah.
Okay.
We could do ga. Let's actually try ga. That'll be hilarious. So I'm gonna go ga, 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 ga.
Wow.
Ga, 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 ga. Big energy, so these hands can be helpful. Ga, 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 ga. Now let's try go.
Go.
Different they feel.
Go, 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 go,
like balance. Yeah, just those are two so far apart, and the just the jump between the two is
chest
like
voice.
You have to really coordinate things. Yeah.
So the reason I chose go, we moved out of gap to mm-hmm. go, is because ad's really wide and it's going to inhibit transitioning. Mm-hmm. And I was like, I'm going to start being really shouty. O brings things more narrow, so it mm-hmm. helps you to navigate through that transition. And the g brings the larynx down a little bit. So it's really, there is a lot of like thought that went into why that happened.
Right.
So really great exercise to practice if you want to improve your pitch. And experiment with a whole bunch of different vowel and consonant combinations, because everyone's going to feel different through your range.
Right.
And you'll learn a lot.
That's true. Mm-hmm.
So there's our warm-up.
Thanks for warming us up.
I think that's really fun. Mm-hmm. I like that we're doing
these. It's fun.
These.
Okay.
Okay, so it's time to talk about... Oh, wait, no, we're not going to do that
yet. I think before we go anywhere else,
Julius,
we should give away some prizes. Because why not? This is our first kind of show.
It's so exciting.
And why not?
So just in case, we're going to be picking prizes out of our member attendees. So if you're a Singeo mm-hmm. member, you're first on the list for prizes. If you're joining us on YouTube, you
quickly
can...
quickly start your trial.
Yeah,
join us in the chat.
It's linked at the top of the YouTube chat. If you just click the little link, it says Singeo, get full access to Singeo membership. It's a free 7-day trial. So you can get in, cost you nothing. You'll be able to like go and access all of the lessons and the routines and all of the fun stuff. And then you'll just be like,
okay, this is what should we give away?
Okay, let's start with a mug.
Okay, we're gonna give away a mug. We're gonna play a little bit of...
Singeo mugs in here.
No, we do not currently. We should get some for next time.
We have cool mugs though.
Let's play a game of Singeo trivia.
Okay.
I have a couple of questions that I thought of that probably most of you can't answer, some of them at least. So I don't know.
And I'm not necessarily going to pick the first answer in the chat.
You'll
I'm
just pick the
whatever.
First one you see?
Kind of,
that's
yeah.
That's fair.
Yeah, just...
Okay.
So.
So you just have to be like, it's like on the radio where you have to be caller number 17. You don't know.
You don't know. Megan just says, let it be. She's answering already. Megan, that's funny.
You know, that's like in Bible school when you just answer Jesus to every question.
Because
you know it's going to be right.
That's the answer.
Okay. So, Singeo trivia. Here's your first question. Okay, are you ready to pick a winner?
Yeah.
Okay. Which Singeo coach taught us how to gargle with apple cider vinegar?
Ooh.
Oh! Megan, Tim.
Okay, yeah, I did see Megan first this time. Megan, you are gonna win a mug.
Okay.
Kay.
Excellent.
Okay, okay.
Do you remember that? And she's like, I think she was like diluted, obviously. Don't
yeah,
ever
I thought that
like,
was
drink
a bit
it straight.
Great. I was like,
you know, because everyone has their own weird
little things, that you
they're
do
like
for your voice.
Procedures they like to do, and it's like, this helps me sing better.
Okay.
Right? It's like, so her thing was all like
apple
diluted
vinegar.
Apple cider vinegar, just like gargle with it, and that was her thing.
Yeah. There you go. Congratulations, Megan. Can you send an email to Julia to remind her to send you a mug?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Next
question. What is the song that Lisa and Tony Lindsay sing as a duet?
That was one of the best moments of my life.
Lisa and Tony sing as a duet.
Dan's
got it. My endless love.
It was the best, like seriously,
great.
I thought I was in heaven.
Yeah.
I was just like, and we sang it a whole bunch of times, but it was literally like, I felt like it was an out of body experience.
Really?
Tony's voice is like.
He's a great singer. Like, he's so good.
Okay, let's do a couple more.
Okay, do you want to pick one?
Yeah. Okay, what are the three things every singer has control over? What are the three things?
This is like method level one. That's one.
That's one. I want to see all three.
Yeah. Okay. Dan, like mouth shape and vowels are kind of the same. Like the shape is the vowels.
Shape and vowels are the same thing. You guys are almost there.
Pitch is really what is produced at the...
Okay, you know what? I'm going to give this one to Isabel Horswell.
Oh,
Isabel, that's vocal cords, yeah. Space, which I'll interpret as space, like, and like breath. Shapes.
Yeah. Yeah,
that's Isabel, it. Isabel, you got it.
Okay.
Timmy, we're so close.
There's, yeah, the three things and how we talk about them in level one of the method are breath, shape, and vocal cords. Which totally, so vocal cords do produce your pitch. Like to some degree, all of those are right. Shape is basically your vowel shapes. So, like, all of you are, like, definitely really close. Yeah.
So close. And none of, like, your answers weren't wrong.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's all very close.
What we teach in the method is that you're in control of your breath. That's what sets your vocal cords into vibration. You're in charge of your vocal cords, whether they're coming together to resist the air or blowing apart. And you're in charge of the shapes that you make with your mouth. So when you are, like, really dialed into those three things, you can accomplish a whole lot with your voice. Mm-hmm. So if there's ever, like, a vocal issue or a struggle, it's usually related to one of those three things. Mm-hmm. Everything else is sort of secondary to them.
Okay. One more question.
One more.
I would do maybe this one. Do you like
that? Ooh, I do like this one.
Okay. Okay. Next question. What is Kate Canning's original song call that we learn in her coach feature?
Tim! Groupie!
Tim's got it.
Tim, you win a t-shirt or a mug.
Nice.
Okay, we're doing a lightning. We're doing one last one.
Okay.
Okay, this one everybody knows the answer to. I'm picking it.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, final one. This is a wild card. What is my favorite food?
Hint, we may have already talked about it.
Sandy was first, and everybody also has it.
Okay, we're gonna do prizes to Sandy and Ogma.
Nice.
I'm giving two away. Sandy and Ogma, you win either a t-shirt or a mug. Email Julia. All the winners, email Julia.
Yeah.
We'll take care of you.
Okay, email Julia at singeo.com and we will figure it out from there.
That was so fun. I loved it.
Singeo trivia.
Pizza's a good guess, BCM.
Yeah.
I do also love pizza.
A close second.
My kid works at a pizza store now.
Oh.
So he brings...
Do you get free pizza?
Every Friday he gets, like, a free pizza.
Nice.
Or every Saturday, and he always, like, makes our favorite and brings it home for us. And it's the cutest thing in the whole wide world.
That's perfect. Yeah. Oh, dream job.
Dream job. The kid's only 12, and he's like, Mom, I'm getting a job. And I'm like,
nice.
What? Really dedicated.
Kids work
no, it's not really.
Okay.
Kind of sketchy.
But he's just helping.
Yeah, he's just helping. But he loves it so much.
Cool.
I'm like, who is this child with his
that's fun.
Job?
No, that's
and
great.
He likes money. So
who doesn't?
I mean, that's what it comes down to. Okay, what's next? We have more things.
We should talk about pitch.
Yeah.
This is a good warm-up. And this I think some of those warm-up. Exercises already played into is like, hey, how can we improve our pitch? I feel like for lots of singers, I don't know. You're either one of two people as a singer. Either you can sing and you don't really have to think about your pitch and it just comes out naturally sort of right. Like, it means your ear just can recognize and reproduce pitch correctly.
Yeah.
And for others, this is a lot harder.
Mm-hmm.
So it's very difficult to actually train your ear. It's really difficult to, like, even know, am I singing the right notes if you don't have the ear to be like, yes, this matches or not. So, I don't know, it's worth a conversation.
Yeah.
And but regardless of what stage you're in, we can all improve our pitch because all human voices are flawed.
Yeah.
We don't, like, no human voice produces a pitch that's like, you know, the pitch on the piano or whatever.
Unless you're Brandi Carlile.
No. I mean, no. Like, her pitch wavers like crazy,
okay,
right?
Fine.
So, like, if you've ever sung into a pitch app and you've seen the needle move, it's like, oh my gosh, it's actually very, very difficult to sing a pitch, like, right in the middle of the pitch, right?
Yeah.
It's nearly impossible.
Yeah. I would say, little story moment. So I've told this to you guys before lots of times, but if you're new, this is a good story for you. I was in the studio, I was recording vocals for my friend, and he was editing them, like he was touching them up after it recorded, and I was in the room listening, and I nearly cried. I was like, I'm never singing again. I was like, I can't believe, I thought I'd done such a great job, but when you hear your voice back with like nothing else,
that's terrible.
I was like, I suck. I'm never singing again. It's just normal.
Yeah. No,
right?
I've definitely felt that way before, too. It's like, oh my gosh, I can't sing at all.
And there's some research that correlates exposure to music in your early childhood with your
ear, like pitch recognition,
and musical development later in life. It's not like a hard and fast rule if you didn't get a lot of music in your home, but if you have more exposure to music, nursery rhymes, and being read to, you're more likely to have development in your ear, your pitch, and your rhythm. So not to say you can't develop that outside of
it's very interesting because pitch is like, it is like two things. It's like the ear sending the message to the brain telling you this is that note, but then also to reproduce it, to have you for your brain to tell your muscles what to do to reproduce that note correctly. Like, it's actually quite a process if you think about it. It's kind of crazy where we just go like, you know, don't even think about it.
No.
It's like all these things happen in a split second. Like,
it becomes super interesting. Yeah. So if you have kids or nieces and nephews or grandkids, the more music, the better. Even if they don't actively participate, just tapping along and
to the Beatles.
Hearing it. Yeah, please like put the Beatles on. Mm-hmm. Skip. Oh gosh, what is that terrible? There's some terrible television shows.
I don't know any kids shows. The Wiggles.
I guess it's not terrible.
Teletubbies.
No, we have to stop.
I don't know.
Also, quick diversion. Debbie is meeting with some Brandi Carlile super fans. To prepare for her show in Durham on Friday.
Oh wow,
that's exciting.
Cool. Oh, I love her so much.
She's so good. Megan makes her kids listen to her Singeo warm-ups. It's perfect.
Nice.
Richard's girls listen to the Beatles in the car all the time.
Of course.
That's amazing.
Oh, speaking of Richard and the Beatles, a quick interruption. So we just finished our, we did a 30-day practice challenge in the forums, and Richard was one of the people participating. And, the goal was to try to post every day and try to sing every day at least, right? Whatever you do. But Richard kind of made himself the challenge to actually, record a Beatles song every day. I think that's right. Yeah. So it was really great. So you should have a look in there and see, a look at some of Richard's songs.
Oh, yeah. If you haven't met Richard in the forums, your life is not as good as
He's
it could
prolific.
Be.
Prolific.
It's just the best. Go watch those. Yeah. Okay. So back to pitch. Pitch can be developed. We do like the idea. What's the name of your pitch app?
I like the Carl Tune. It's a weird name, but it's free. And I like that it shows you all the note names. It shows you the keyboard, like a piano keyboard as well, which is kind of interesting because sometimes as singers, sometimes it's hard to hear what octave you're singing in, especially if you're maybe trying to match a female or your male or something like it's very difficult to hear where you're actually singing. And it's like, what's my range?
Yeah.
So I like seeing like a physical keyboard with the notes being highlighted that you're singing. And it tells you, hey, this is A3. Because that's really how we talk about where that A is on the keyboard, right?
Yeah.
And then it has a needle that's not too crazy, which I also like.
Okay,
so
that's nice.
It's actually pretty steady.
Okay, what's the name of that one again?
Carl Tune.
C-A-R-L?
Yeah, Carl Tune, that one.
Okay.
People typed it in.
Yeah.
That's perfect. So it's just it's not like a be all end all. You're not going to be able to sing a song and know if you've got all the notes accurate, but it's fun to kind of test yourself and just experience that.
Yeah, this is that's a very analytical thing you can do. But if it's like, you know what? Let me play this note, sing it back. Sorry, it's really low. That's as far as I can reach. Sing it into your pitch app. And see if you at least get the same letter name, right? All we want is okay, that's an E. E. Okay.
Yeah.
So that's a great way to kind of test yourself, to be like, hey, how reliable is my ear and my pitch?
It's a great thing to test.
So yeah. So that's just called pitch matching. And that's really a very basic skill for any singer. It's sing any note, hear it, sing it back. And then check yourself either on a piano if you can, if you have the ear to do that, or an instrument, or on an app.
Yeah, do it. 100% do it. Now, the other thing is listening to yourself back. So listen to yourself, record your practices. They're not meant to be pretty. Remember this always. And I know it's hard to hear ourselves back.
I know.
But listening back will help you to understand if you're super accurate or not. And if you aren't sure, what is the best thing to do? Send in your video for student reviews.
True.
Just send it. We're going to look at the video. We're going to give you feedback. And the more you tell us in your review submission, the better. So if you're like, I'm worried about my pitch on these notes. These are the things I've tried. I don't know if it's working. Can you tell me? Then we're really able to specifically address what you're wanting feedback on. So you got to keep going. And Wendy, yes, record some singing. When you feel like you want to quit, that's the time to really focus on songs that you love and maybe let go a little bit of the perfectionism.
Right. I was just going to say too, just find some songs that inspire you, that you love, where you just want to sing along. No pressure to be anything or sound like anything. Just forget about any exercises or like goals or whatever. Just like have fun and just get re-inspired. And I think out of that, often for me at least, come like new goals of like, hey, wait, I found this new song that I now really want to learn. And it has like this challenge in it that now I need to master. So,
yes. Yeah. I also think too, like, we're here as a vocal education space. But we're also here to be your encouragers, and there's more to singing than getting it right. Right. Like, so much more to singing than getting it right. It's so good for our souls, it is really and our good. Moods, yeah. and our well-being. It's so
very cheap therapy.
Very cheap therapy, for sure. Basically free.
Sorry, but what were you gonna say?
I do remember.
Pitch something. Was it about something. Cake? Pitch. No, no, no. Dang it.
Right idea. You have to exercise your voice. You have to record yourself back. You have to submit for student reviews. Yourself back. Listen back.
What do you feel like are the most helpful exercises for people to work on their pitch?
The ones we did today. Creaky door.
Creaky door.
And gug. Those are my top three. Mm-hmm. And then practice those octaves. They're super fun.
Yeah.
And challenging. You can find all of these, like, just go to our routines. I should have brought my iPad so I could screen share with you. I'll do that next week. But you go to our routine section, just click on any of the routines and supplement the exercises that the routine tells you to do.
We actually have like a pitch training routine in the routine section now, which is great.
It's really great.
I feel like the other thing you can do if you're somebody that struggles with pitch is to work on your ear training.
Yeah.
And this is maybe like, there's less singing involved. This is like a bit of a drier skill. Like, it's really just training your ear to recognize. But for example, learning intervals is one of the most helpful things you can do for your ear. Yeah. It's really just like going, okay, this is one, this is two, one, two, that's it, major, second, three, four, five, six, seven, one.
Don't you have this in our theory level?
We do.
I mean, our we have theory in the method and harmony.
Harmony, yes. So you can go to level 9, and there's like a whole lesson that teaches you all the intervals with little helper songs. Let's have a quick tip on ear training.
We do. And if now that you guys have access to all of the Musora platforms, you can head into Pianote and into the quick tips in Pianote. Kevin has a quick tip on training your ear. It's very comprehensive. There's lots of assignments.
Nice.
And it's going to help you like a ton.
Yeah.
So, I want to take some time just to let that set. Sink in.
Okay.
We're going to answer a few questions before we run out of time. It's already 10:45.
There's one thing we have to do.
What?
Before we do anything else.
Oh, no.
Is we have to introduce our student of the week.
That's the most important.
Yes. I don't know if she's here, but our student of the week for this week is Ingrid. Ingrid Poulsen, I think, is maybe her name. Ingrid's from like the Scottish Highlands. So I've actually like asked her to be like, can you like sing anything in a Scottish accent for me, please?
Oh my gosh, that's amazing.
So Ingrid is our student of the week. I think she came over from Pianote and hasn't been with us for super long yet, but like I love that first thing she did, like right away as she arrived, she sent in a student review to be like, you know what? I just want to get an assessment of where I'm at and what I need to work on. Perfect. That's really good. And then if you go through any of the student reviews or anybody's like posts in their forums, the first comment there is always Ingrid. Like the most encouraging, which I love. And then she's started to post videos of herself singing too. Ingrid was part of her 30-day practice challenge in the month of September. And did an amazing job, just like being very diligent with it. It's so hard to practice every single day.
it's very difficult.
And then to actually post about it too. Like, oh man, I failed a couple of times in the middle there.
Did you?
Yeah. Then I had to like make up, or then I didn't, or I have to do like a catch up post to be like, this is the last 3 days. Ingrid, congratulations. Can we have a little listen at Ingrid's song that she shared? It's really good.
Somewhere over the rainbow, way up high, there's a land that I heard of once in a lullaby. Somewhere, the dream
gosh, it's beautiful. I loved it.
Yeah. So it congrats. Student of the week.
Okay. So we have a question. And you guys, throw questions. We got a couple minutes to chat about questions before we have to go. But Jeffrey was asking about why certain words throw me off pitch, which is a great pitch-related question.
This is true. Yeah.
So the three things we're in control of: vocal cords, breath, and the shape we make. So sometimes the shapes that we're making combined with the note that we're singing on can sort of work against each other a little bit. And we need to adjust our shape to encourage the pitch that we want. So you can kind of think about, like, when you have loud music playing with, like, really lots of bass in it, and you might have things in your house that vibrate on certain notes, that's based on the shape of the item and the pitch. So when we're talking about wanting to have really accurate pitch, sometimes if I'm singing a big note like somewhere, and I'm not, that, I mean, that was really, like, did you hear it was like brassy? It wasn't super pleasing. So I'm going to adjust my shape somewhere. So I completely shifted there the amount of chest voice that I was using, and I did that by shifting the shape I was making, and it was more pleasing. I can even go some, new shape, somewhere. So the shapes we make really do have an impact on pitch. And sometimes it's less like, am I singing C and hitting C? And it's more like, if you've ever tuned a guitar, there's a spectrum of C, right? There's your C, you're in C, but it's to the sharp side of C, or you've got C, but it's to the flat side of C. So when we use our vowels, we can find that sweet spot where we just lock into the pitch perfectly. We have a full course on exactly this topic inside the Singeo membership. It's Darcy's, I think it's called The Power of Vowels?
Sure.
Wait, it's a vowels one. You'll find it. It's really, really helpful. Okay. And you'll learn about how to shape your words so that you get the most out of your notes. Mm-hmm. Okay.
There was a question from Doug. From a little bit ago.
Let's talk about it.
Doug's been saying, I've been doing the daily routine for a strong voice and the daily routine for a healthy voice for a week or so. And it occurs to me that they overlap a
bit. They probably do.
Many of the routines overlap quite a bit.
They do, and they're supposed to.
Right, so does the strong voice routine replace the healthy voice? So many of them are quite different. Yeah.
You know, there's, whoa, did you guys hear that?
That was loud, Lisa.
It's time for lunch.
Can we get a mic on Lisa's stomach?
No, it's too loud. You don't even need a mic. You can hear it screaming. So yeah, they're going to overlap, and some routines will. Go with the one that feels best for you, or adjust the transpose option so that you can practice it in a different key range. And if you're finding that some of the vowel consonant combinations that are suggested are, like, maybe you want to try something different, go for it. Mm-hmm. That's my advice.
Cool.
Okay, we were going to do a song before we left.
Yeah. Let's do it.
Where is it? Count on me.
Do you want to play the piano also?
I could try.
Should we do a little, we've never played together.
We've never played at the same time. Can we do it? Are we doing this in C?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll just play like a little bit.
Yeah.
Are you singing the first verse?
How do you miss? Well, yeah, or you do. Either way.
You do it.
Okay. If you ever find yourself stuck in the middle of the sea, I'll sail the world.
You guys have to sing along.
To find you. And if you ever find yourself lost in the dark and you can't see, I'll be the light to guide you. Find out what we're made of when we are called to help our friends in need. You can count on me like one, two, three. I'll be.
I can sing a harmony.
A lower one? I know when I'm needed, I can count.
cutest song in the world. So cute!
What?
Oh my
That's
god.
That's way too cute.
Okay, so keep smiling, everyone. That made me smile.
Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for hanging out.
So fun.
We're going to do this again next week. Mm-hmm. I made a thread in the forums. Ooh. So if you guys have like any cool news about what's happening in the singing world that you are interested in us highlighting, or song requests for us to perform, or you just want to talk a little bit about what we talked about here and keep the conversation going, you can just find that in there. The forums.
Yeah.
So thanks for being here. Mm-hmm. Come back next week. Have an awesome day. And we'll see you around. You can't count on